So it's easy to fall in the gravel on the trails, mm-hmm. and there's plenty of rocks to trip over, so be careful. Uh-huh. Also, you can see there's a big circular path here you walk around. Uh-huh. It's very nice to walk the circle and check out different spots and look up and see the cave above you in a different angle. Mm-hmm. And we don't go to the elevator area unless we're just leaving or arriving, because this is the safety precaution. Okay. So also, if you want to know how the cave was formed, scientists aren't completely agreed, but the main theory is that you can see the black lines here on the right and on the left here. Mm-hmm. This is what we call a magma intrusion. So magma was traveling underground from 7 kilometers away, underground with a lot of pressure, and the rock around was breaking up. So we had a fissure eruption. The rock was breaking, magma came up. But the strange thing is that the magma creating this dome-shaped cave is very unusual. Mm-hmm. And they think it might be because of this thin black layer here, mm-hmm. which is similar to palagonite, like sand rock.
Yeah.
But this one is very, very, very soft. You can almost just take with your hand.
Uh-huh. Yeah.
So maybe the magma came and managed to erode it away, creating this dome shape before the magma went up and created the scoria cone above you.
Uh-huh.
So then usually a volcano would stop and the magma inside would just be harden and you would have a solid volcano. But in this case, there was a pressure drop and the magma went down. Mm-hmm. And they think, scientists, that it kept on going to the north and erupted a small eruption a little bit further down, but leaving the cave empty. Yeah. So we have this magma tube that's left empty.
Right.